Hello students, welcome to video lecture series on C programming. In this video lecture series I am going to explain every aspect of C programming. Myself Dr. P.S. Tambe, I am working as associate professor in physics. I am teaching C programming and computational physics from last 20 years at TY BSc Physics and MSc Physics level. This course is according to syllabus of Savitribai Phule Pune University for physics courses. But this one is useful for computer science students, engineering students, mathematics students, and so on. In this lecture series, I will start from introduction of C programming, then I will cover control statements, arrays, pointers, functions, user-defined functions, then graphics and simulations of physics systems. I will also cover numerical analysis. I will show live demonstrations of C programs using Turbo C++ compiler. For every program that I will going to take, first I will explain algorithm or flowchart in detail, and then the same algorithm or flowchart will be converted into a C program. I will try to make this course as interesting as possible, and I am sure you will enjoy this course, and at the end of this course, you will be able to write C programs comfortably. In the first lecture, I will start from introduction of C, then character set used in the C programming, and structure of C programming. Welcome to first lecture on introduction of C programming. In this lecture, I am going to cover introduction of C programming, structure of C program, character set, keywords, constant and variables, variable names, data types and declarations. So here we'll go to introduction. C is procedural programming language. It was initially developed by Dennis Ritchie in the year 1972 at Bell Telephone Laboratory in USA for telephone communications. C is general purpose language. It is structured programming language. It is very easy to understand because the set of instructions in C are general words of English, such as if, else, while, do while, do, for, etc. The main feature of C language include low level access to memory, a simple set of keywords, and clean style of writing. These features make C language suitable for system programming, like an operating system or compiler development. C programming language is mother of all programming languages, because once you know C language, you can easily learn any other programming language like Visual Basic, Basic, Java, .NET, and so on. Now here we see simple C window. When we open Turbo C compiler, and from file menu, if we choose new file, then this window will open. In this window, we write C program. So this is the space available for C program. You can go below, so you can write very big program also, having number of statements. Now, if we go to, suppose I take simple program here. So I will go to file, then I will take new, and then I will write simple program, hash, include stdio.h, then hash include onivo.h, then I can write here hash define some pi, then space 3.141159, then I will write here main. So I am writing program in C window. Then I can write here int. Now if I write int and give space bar, that int becomes white. Then I can write I, J, K. And then I can use here CLR, SCR. This is some function. I will explain later on. Then I can write I is equal to 5, J is equal to 6. Then I can write K is equal to I plus J. And then I will write here printf in double quote K is equal to %d, double quote is completed, comma K, bracket is completed, comma, double quote is completed here, comma K, and then semicolon. And then I will write here get ch. Then semicolon, and then I will complete this bracket. And I can run this program, and I will get here. So I got two errors. So I can find that errors also. So here it is wrong one. So I write here stdio.h. Then I will run here again. So this is output screen, and on the output screen I got k equal to 11. So this is simple C program I have taken here. Now see here this part. So here if we go to this part, this is called preprocessor. For any C program, there will be preprocessors. Has include in angular bracket stdio.h, bracket is completed. This is always required. Then has include in angular bracket conio.h. Then I have defined here using this. Then main. This is main function. That is also required in C programming. Without main, your C program will not work. You can write this main as while main while also. Or you can simply write main in bracket while. Now here, what is meaning of this while and this while? Means main function does not take any argument or it does not return any value. That is meaning of this. So you can simply write like this. And now after main, using this left brass, we start the program. And with right brass, we end the program. So this is called body of program. And in this bracket, we write statements. These are also called instructions. So this is first statement, int I, comma j, comma k, semicolon. Then I equal to 5, j equal to 6, k is equal to I plus j. And this is the statement, printf statement. So here, these are statements we have written in this bracket. When we run this program, first control of the program execute these statements. Means that control include files stdio.h, include file conio.h, then it can define, take this value also, and then it enters in main. And when it goes here, one by one, it executes statements. So this is simple structure of C program. When, and this is output screen. So what is C? Preprocessor. The preprocessor is a collection of special statements called directives. Now, what are directives? Means directives are instructions given for statements in C program. So here, general preprocessors are include, has define, has if, has else, has end if define. We have seen in program, has include and has define. These four, I will explain later on, when we encounter with such programs. Now, has include in angular bracket stdio.h. Dot h. This is extension, and that file is called header file. Header file. And this is part of C compiler. And there are number of header files. And we have to include these header files in our program depending upon the requirement. Here include has include is called as a preprocessor. And stdio.h is standard input output header file. A header file is a file with extension.h which contains C function declarations and macro definitions to be shared between several source files. Now, suppose we want to calculate this y is equal to sqrtx. X is variable, y is variable, and sqrt it is math function. So if we do not include math.h file, then the program will show error. That is called prototype error. Because square root function, sqrt function, it is defined in math.h file. It is not present in stdio.h file or conio.h file. Then there are other files also, graphics.h, complex.h. These are some header files, or you can have stdlib.h and so on. And these preprocessors are required in C program. Without preprocessors, C program will not work. Now we will go to character set. I have taken that program again here. Now, if we see this program carefully, this program, it is written using characters. So, if we see this program, it is written using characters. Now, here, we can use letters in the program. And letters are, you can use A, B, C, up to Z, that are lowercase letters. You can use capital A, capital B, up to capital Z. You can use 0, 1, 2, up to 9, that are digits. And keep in mind that this small a, that is lowercase a and uppercase a, or lowercase b and uppercase b, these are not the same characters for C compiler. They are different characters. So small a is different than capital A. Now if we see here program, in program we have used hash, we have used here period, then comma, semicolon, percent, then these brackets. So these are special characters. And C program use this type of special characters, means it will use these special characters. So C program means we can use comma, we can use colon, quotation mark, slash, underscore, hash, asterisk, opening angle brace, right parenthesis, left brace, period, question mark, एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क, बैक स्लैश, डॉलर साइन, परसेंट साइन, टाइड, कैरेट, प्लस. सो दीज आर स्पेशल कैरेक्टर्स यू कैन यूज इन द प्रोग्राम. ऑल दीज स्पेशल कैरेक्टर्स आर अवेलेबल ऑन योर कीबोर्ड. And using these special characters and letters and digits, you can write your C program. And that C program will be written according to structure of C program. That structure I have just explained to you. Then we will go to keywords and identifiers. What are keywords? Keywords are the reserved words which cannot be used in program as variable names. All keywords have standard and predefined meanings and functions, which are already defined in C compiler. Again, I will take program here, and if you go to this program, here I have int. This int is keyword. This is keyword. And it has a specific meaning and specific function. And there is set of keywords. Like atto, do, go to, signed, unsigned, break, double, if, size of, while, case, else, int, static, volatile, char, enum, long, struct, while, const, extern, register, switch, continue, float, return, type def, default, or short, for, short, union. In all, there are 32 keywords available in C. Now, these keywords have specific meaning, specific functions, so you cannot use these keywords for other purposes in C programming language. Now, there are identifiers. Identifiers are the names given to various program elements, such as variables, functions and arrays. So if we go to this program again, here I have I, J and K. These are variables. Means these are names of variables. And I can assign value to each variable. Now, you can write variables by using letters, digit and underscores. So you can write here A, you can use A, X, capital A. Now this small a and capital A, these are two different variables. You can write variable using combination of characters also. You can write file, underscore, name. Then you can write X1, underscore, N. Means you can write here int, underscore n. You can declare like this. Only special character used in the variable name is underscore. You cannot use other special characters to write identifiers. So these examples I have shown, these are valid names given to identifiers. What are invalid identifiers? If you write identifier like this, 2A. So 2A means it starts with digit. This is not allowed. Then if you take X space 2, space is not allowed. Then here double quote A. This is not allowed because we have used here special characters, double quotes. File name. Here we have used dash, that is not allowed. Then if you take X question mark, X is okay, but due to question mark, this is not allowed because you cannot use special characters except underscore in identifiers. So this is about identifiers. So keywords and identifiers, these are two important factors in C programming. Now we'll go to variables. What is meaning of variable? Variable is an entity that has a value and is known to program by its name. We have seen int, I, J, K in previous program, and I have given I equal to 5. So I is variable name, and we give value to that variable, it is 5. Now variable definition means here int I, comma j, comma k, this is definition. So declaration of variable. Now variable definition associates a memory location with the variable name. Means when we declare variables like int I, comma j, comma k, and when we run program, and when program control executes this statement, it allocates memory to I, J, K by the name I, J, K. And if I write I equal to 5, then that 5 is stored at the memory location of I. A variable can have only one value assigned to it at any given time during the execution of program. Means at an instant, the variable will have single value. But as control goes forward during the execution of program, value of that variable may change. Means here, initially suppose I is 5, then during the execution of program, I can become 6 also. So that value may change, but at an instant it will have single value. Now, here I have taken int I, comma j, comma k. What is meaning of int? That int is called data type. Means type of IJK variables. In C programming, there are four basic data types. Character data type, this variable, which is, if it is character variable, it can hold one character. Means you can define like this, CHARA. Means this variable will hold a character. Means at the memory location of A, we can store character. If I take int, it is an integer type variable. Just we have seen int I, J, K here. So I is integer type variable, J is integer type variable, and K is integer type variable. And according to that, memory is reserved. Now if we go to float, it is used for real numbers. Means you can write here float x. So this x is real number variable and it is called single precision floating point number. You can have double y. So this y is double precision floating point number. And this differentiation, it is due to requirements of memory that I am going to explain you later on. So we have four basic data types, char, int, float, double. You can have derived data types also. Means you can have long int, short int, unsigned int, signed int, signed char, unsigned char, and so on. So these are called derived data types. You can have user defined data types also. So user can define data types. Now if we see here, variable declaration. So how can we declare variables? So if we see here, these are processors used. There is stdio.h also. Then main, then we have written here statements. So int ijk means ijk, these are integer variables. Float x, y, z, these are real number variables, floating point variables. Now I equal to 5 means 5 is given to I, 6 is assigned to j, and then this is expression. Then I have x equal to 5, so 5 is assigned to x, 6 is assigned to y, and then I have again expression. Now each expression is evaluated from right to left. Here also right to left. Now, if we see values of I, j, that is 5 and 6 respectively, x and y, 5 and 6 respectively, so k and z both will give you value equal to 11, and that values are printed using printf statement. Now what happens here, when we run program, first preprocessors are executed, then control will enter. Then control will enter in the main function. Then first it will execute this statement. When control executes this statement, what happens? Memory locations are reserved by the name I, J, K. Then when this statement is executed, then three memory locations are reserved in the computer's memory by the name X, Y, and Z. Then this statement is executed, means value 5 is assigned to I, means what happens? Control goes to memory location and stores 5 there. When this statement is executed, 6 is stored at the memory location of J. And then K is equal to I plus J, means what happens here? Value of I is called from the memory location here. Value of J is called from the memory location here. Then addition is taken, that process is present in .h file. And whatever result of that addition, it is assigned to K, so 11 is stored here. Then control goes here, next statement is this. So 5 is stored at the memory location of X, 6 is stored at the memory location of Y, and then this expression is evaluated, 11 is assigned to Z, so 11 is stored here. Then printf function. So to printf values of K and Z, value is called from the memory location of K. Value is called from the memory location of Z. And that value is printed, and you will get values of K equal to 11 and Z equal to 11 on the output screen. Now, we will see this program, we will run this program. Now, here I have simple program, I will write here int ijk, then float x comma y comma z I equal to 5, j equal to 6, k is equal to I plus j, and then I will write x is equal to 5, y is equal to 6, and then I will write expression here, z is equal to x plus y, and then we will use printf statement, printf k is equal to %d, then z is equal to, I can take %f, and I can write here kz. So this is simple program, and if we run this program, now see, k is equal to 11 is printed, z is equal to 11 is printed, but see format of z. So z is equal to 11.000000. So we have 6 decimal places by default. So what is meaning of this? Means k is stored differently, z is stored differently. So whatever memory required to store K and memory required to store Z, they may be different memories. and that we have to see here. So in this program, K and J are printed differently, and they are according to their memory requirements. So memory requirements of X, Y, Z and I, J, K are different. So integer variables take different memory and float variables take different memory. So if I take here int I, J, float X, Y, double Z, character A, I, J, integer type variables, float X, Y, floating type variables, Z, that is also floating type, but its data type is double, character char a is character type variable, then I equal to 5, I have assigned 5 to I, 2.3 to X, and A is equal to single quote C. So when we want to assign character to character variable, you have to write that character in single quote. Now, for each variable, memory is allocated. So if we see, suppose this is computer's memory. Now here 1 square, it is 1 byte. 1 byte means 8 bits, because variable or value is stored in the computer's memory in the form of binary digits, that is zeros and ones. 1 byte means 8 bits, so it can store 8 bits. So 1 byte is nothing but 8 bit, and in this 8 bits, number is stored or variable is stored, value of variable is stored in the form of ones and zeros. Means whatever value of variable, that is converted into binary number and that is stored there. Now what is memory requirement of I and J? What is memory requirement of X and Y? What is memory requirement of Z? And what is memory requirement of A? That we will take. So here, if we take, for I and J, means for I, 2 byte memory is required. So what happens when control comes here, 2 byte memory, it is assigned to I by the name I. Then 2 byte memory is assigned to J, this is assigned to J, value of J is stored here. If we go to float XY, so when this statement is executed, 4 byte memory, 4 byte means 32 bits, it is assigned to X as well as Y. If we take double Z, means here for Z, 8 byte memory is assigned. If we take character A, for A, 1 byte memory is assigned. So what happens? Here you can have 4 byte for X, and that is assigned randomly in the computer's memory. 4 byte for Y, 8 byte for Z, and 1 byte for A. So in this way, memory is assigned. And then when this statement is executed, 5 is assigned to I, so 5 is stored at this location. 2.3, it is stored at this location. C, it is stored at the location, suppose this is location for A, this 1 byte, then C is stored here in the memory location of A. But all these numbers and characters are stored in the form of binary numbers. So if we go to integer type variables, so if I take int I takes 2 byte memory, so I have shown here 2 byte memory. This is 2 byte memory. And number is stored from this to this. This is called 0th bit, 1st bit, 2nd bit, and this is 15th bit. So in all there are 16 bits. And this bit, it is called lower significant bit. And this is called higher significant bit. Now see here red. I have filled this bit with red. Now, this out of 16 bits, this is the first bit. First means 15th bit, 0 to 15th. This bit is reserved for sign of the number. So if I write int I, first, this first bit is reserved for sign, and only these 15 bits are available to store the number. So if I give some I equal to some number, then that number is stored in the form of binary in that 15 bits. Suppose I equal to 0, means it is positive. In sign bit, 0 is stored, and in remaining 15 bits, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 are stored. If we have 1, suppose we take 1, then what happens here? We get 1 here, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 up to this, and 0 here. If we have 2, then we have here 1, 0, and remaining are zeros. And this is 0. 2 is positive number. So in this way, numbers are filled. Then what is the maximum value of integer I that I can take? So I can have integer whose all bits are 1, 1, 1, 1, means all 15 bits are 1, 1, 1. And this sign bit is 0 because it is positive number. Then I can calculate value by simple binary to decimal conversion. So I can write here 0 into 2 raised to 15 plus 1 into 2 raised to 14 plus 1 into 2 raised to 13 and so on. Go up to 1 into 2 raised to 0. And then calculate this number. So this is 32,767. That is the maximum value I can give to integer A. So this is maximum range that of integer type variable. Then what is minimum value it can store? So this is maximum value, minimum value. So minus 1, minus 2, up to what? So what is meaning of minus 1? So when number is negative, this first bit stores 1. And when all bits are 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, then this number is called minus 1. What is minus 2? So subtract 1, binary 1 from this. So I will get 0 here. This is minus 2. Then subtract again minus 1, means 1, subtract 1. But this is binary subtraction, so you have to subtract binary number 1. Then I will get minus 3. Then subtract again 1, I will get minus 4. So go on subtracting. Finally, I will get all bits that are 0, 0, 0 except this first bit. Except this first bit. Because it is used for sign. And this is the minimum number. And if you calculate using 1 into 2 raised to 15 plus 0 into 2 raised to 14 plus so on 0 into 2 raised to 0, I will get 32768 and I will give here sign minus. So minus 2 raised to 15. So range of integer data type I can write. It is from minus 32768 to 32767 including 0. So this is a range of integer data type. Now suppose I want more value than this one. 32,767. Then I have to change memory requirement of that integer variable. So how can we change? To change that, we can use qualifiers. So first qualifier, I can say unsigned int I. What is meaning of unsigned? Means this number is positive. This variable is positive number. So I take 2 byte memory, no problem. But whatever bit reserved for sign, it is now available to store the number. So what happens here? All 16 bits are available to store the number and you can give only positive number. So here 0, all 16 bits are 0. Maximum, all 16 bits are 1, 1, 1, 1, and so on. So I can find out maximum value. It comes out to be 2 raised to 16 minus 1. Means you can calculate this. 1 into 2 raised to 15 plus 1 into 2 raised to 14 plus 1 into 2 raised to 13 and so on plus 1 into 2 raised to 0. Calculate this. You will get this value. 6, 5, 5, 3, 5. So if I have unsigned data type, then its range it is 0 to 6, 5, 5, 3, 5. This is the maximum number I can store if I use this qualifier unsigned int I. Then you can have long int I. So long is qualifier used here. Now long, when we use long qualifier to int I, then it takes 4 byte memory. Out of 4 bytes, first bit, it is used for sign, and remaining 31 bits used to store the integer number in the form of binary. Then unsigned long int I, this is other qualifier. It also takes 4 byte memory, but here all 32 bits are available to store the number. So when we declare any integer variable, int I or long int, then and then suppose I take I equal to 5. So what happens when compiler computer control executes this statement, memory location is reserved, then 5 is assigned to I, means compiler takes this value 5, converts it into binary number and then store at the memory location of I. So in this way, values are stored at the memory location. So on the basis of that, you can find ranges of different data types. If we take here character or signed char, it takes 1 byte memory, signed one, that is 8 bit. So its range is minus 128 to 127. If we use, now we have seen int data type, 2 byte memory, unsigned it, 2 byte memory, but range is this. Short int, you can reduce memory requirement of integer also. If you use short int, then it is just 1 byte memory or 8 bit memory. Long int, we have just seen, unsigned int, we have just seen, and they ranges. Float, it is just 4 byte memory, means 32 bit memory, and its range can be 3.4 e minus 38, means 3.4 into 10 raised to minus 38 to 3.4 into 10 raised to 38. For double, 8 byte memory, that is 64 bit, and this is the range, 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 308 to 1.7 into 10 raised to 308. Long double, it uses 10 byte memory, that is 80 bit memory, and this is the range of long byte, long double. So these are memory requirements of different data types and their ranges. So when computer control executes any declaration statement, it assigns memory according to data types. And when we assign value to that variable, that value is stored in the form of binary numbers. But if we see character data type, so here in this program we have char A. So is A is character variable, so memory is reserved in the memory location, and that memory is 1 byte by the name A. And when we take A equal to single quote C, then C is stored in the binary form. Now we have seen conversion of integer numbers into binary, conversion of real numbers into binary, but how can we convert character into binary? So for that purpose, one standard code information is there. That is called ASCII values. ASCII means American Standard Code for Information Interchange. And this is character encoding standard for electronic communication. And this is same for all programming languages. So what happens here? When we take A equal to single quote C, means this C, it is a character. It has assigned ASCII value. So when C is stored at the memory location, means that ASCII value, decimal value, it is stored in the form of binary in the memory location. If we see here, so A, this is character data type, it requires 8 byte memory, C is stored in that memory in the form of binary number. And this is generally, this is table of ASCII codes. Here, if we see this table, this is binary number, this is decimal number, this is hex number for corresponding character. So for null character, decimal number is 0, corresponding binary is this. SOH. Actually, from this 0 to 31, means for this 32 characters, these are actually control characters. They are used for machine languages. These are ASCII values and corresponding binary numbers. So here, if we go to next one, from 32 here, decimal 32. 32, it is used for space. If we use space, it takes space as a character. And its decimal value, ASCII value is 32. If we take this symbol, its ASCII value is 33. If we take this double quote, its ASCII value is 34, and so on. So for each character, there is ASCII value. So if we go in this way, for question mark, ASCII value is, for question mark, ASCII value is 63. And its corresponding binary number, 8-bit binary number is this one, 00111111. Now if we go here, now if we take character capital A, its ASCII value is 65. If we take character Z, its ASCII value is 90. So when we take character Z and store in the memory, actually this ASCII value in the form of binaries stored in the memory. Now if we go to next one, so I am showing you the table of ASCII values. If we take here small a, its ASCII value is 97. If we see C, its ASCII value is 99. So what happens here? When we take A equal to C, means C is assigned to A, so what happens? Control takes ASCII value of this, that is 99. It converts into binary number, and then that binary number is stored at the memory location of A, and the number is stored like this in the form of binary number. When we want to print A, then what happens? This binary number is called by compiler, the control, it is converted into ASCII value and then its character, and then it is printed. Now keep in mind here, suppose we take here, suppose A equal to 5 and A is character, and if we take int I equal to 5, what is difference between these two? Char A equal to in single quote 5 and int I equal to simply 5. So here this 5, it is taken as character. while this 5 is taken as integer. So what happens, this I has 2 byte memory and this 5 is converted into binary and stored in 2 byte memory. While here this 5 is character and this A requires 1 byte memory, so ASCII value of 5 is taken and then that is stored in the memory. So that is the difference between them. So here if we see 5, so if we see here 5, I can show you 5. So if we see here character 5, its ASCII value is 53. Means here when 5, A equal to single quote 5, means this character 5 is stored at the memory location of A, actually ASCII value 53 is stored in the form of binary. While here actual 5 is stored in the form of binary number at the memory location of I. That is the difference between character 5 and I 5, integer 5. So thank you very much for this lecture. In next lecture, I will cover constants, arithmetic and logical operators. Thank you very much.